Hi kids, it is week 3 of the Loop Show. Woo-hoo! And I brought a friend this time, Coach David.
Hello!
So today we're talking about a special type of courage, the type of courage that takes you out of your comfort zone. In addition to celebrating our mothers this month, we are also celebrating and honoring people during this Memorial Day weekend.
Memorial Day? Uh-oh. Oh no.
What happened?
Oh no, I didn't memorize anything.
Oh my goodness. Relax, Coach David. We're not talking about memorizing anything. Oh. We're actually talking about celebrating the lives of those who made the ultimate sacrifice and were very courageous in fighting for our country and for others around the world.
That's
for their safety
better.
And protection. Yes,
yeah.
I think so.
Whew.
So today, we hope that all of you learn some great advice on how to be courageous in your own lives. Let's check out the video and we'll be back at the end.
Why does Ricky look so nervous?
I don't think I want to do this challenge.
Hang on for the loop.
3, 2, 1.
There's a story in the Bible from the book of Daniel about a king named Nebuchadnezzar. Now this king makes a giant gold statue and he says, "Everybody listen, I love this statue and you will too. I want you to bow down and worship my statue. If you don't, no worries. I'll just, you know, throw you into a blazing furnace." Since it's no fun to be burned alive, all of the people bowed down and worshiped this big gold statue. But there were 3 dudes who wouldn't bow. So, someone went and tattled. He said, "My king, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego aren't bowing because they worship the one true God and not a statue." Now this sent the king into a rage. He ordered that these 3 guys be brought in for a little chat. When they showed up, the king said, "Last chance, bow to my awesome gold statue or I'll straight up throw you into the furnace." Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stood firm with courage. They said, "Dear king, if you throw us into the fire, the God we serve is able to save us. He will rescue us. But even if he doesn't, we want to be crystal clear that we will never bow to your gold statue." This made the king so furious that he had the furnace heated up 7 times hotter than usual. He yelled, "Throw them, clothes and all, into the fire, now!" As Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stood in the flames, suddenly the king jumped up and he said, "Didn't we only throw 3 guys into the fire?" "We sure did," said his advisors. "Look," said the king, "I see 4 men, unbound, walking around in the fire completely unharmed. And the 4th man looks like a god." The king ordered everyone out of the furnace. As Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stepped out, they didn't even smell like smoke. Not a single scorch mark on their clothes or a singed hair on their heads. The king was so amazed by their courage and faith in their god that he issued a decree. No one was to ever speak a word against the god of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Said the king, "Forget the statue. There's no other god who can rescue like this."
Hi, I'm Ricky.
I'm Jamie.
And that was a story from the book of Daniel in the Bible.
Maybe you've heard it before, maybe you haven't, but I know you haven't heard it like that.
Now, this whole month we have been talking about courage, and those guys were super courageous.
Yes, and Ricky, are you feeling courageous?
So here's the thing, because they were put into a furnace that was set to 7 times hotter than usual, we decided to do a spicy challenge.
But I don't like spice, so I will be eating these.
And I will be eating something 7 times hotter than my typical spice level. This is called 100% Pain. This is called The Bomb Beyond Insanity.
Called toothpicks.
Yep, those are called toothpicks. And this is called 1,000,000 Scoville.
But, before you have to do that, now that we know who our main characters are, let's find out who they really are. And then we'll have you eat.
This says
1,000,000 Scoville.
Look at this. This says this is not a sauce or a condiment.
Well, then what is it?
It's a skin irritant.
Oh my.
So who really were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Well, they were these three guys who were taken from their home and brought somewhere completely different, to a different culture, to different people, taken from everything that they knew and everything that they loved, and actually given completely new names. So their original names were Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, which meant something to them, right? It was significant to who they were, to their culture, and everything that they believed. And when they were brought to this new place, everything that they believed was changed when they were given these new names. So for example, I absolutely love cinnamon rolls. And if somebody were to change my name from lover of cinnamon rolls to lover of onions, I would not be okay with it because onions are disgusting, right? And for you, maybe your name meant something like lover of God. So what if somebody changed your name from lover of God to lover of a God that I made up? What if I changed your name? Would you still be able to stand up for something you believe in if everyone around you was telling you you're something that you're not?
Okay, this product can cause serious injury if directly consumed, ingested, or applied to the body.
What? I mean, don't they know that, like, you're gonna eat it? I'm confused. Why don't we go with, like, whichever one looks least painful?
I mean, surprisingly, I feel like pain is the one that's gonna be least painful.
Painful here is La Cracker? Oh, I mean, is that how much you want to do?
Too much? Or that's good? Okay.
Oh.
Don't smell it.
Oh, yeah, okay. If I were to bottle up pain, it would smell like this.
Wow, that's just a little bit, and I think I burned all of my nose hairs.
All right, countdown?
Yeah.
Three, two, one. Oh my gosh, it's so hot. Terribly hot.
Oh. Oh.
Are you okay?
Ooh. Oh. Ooh. Oh. Oh. Ooh. That is a salty boy.
Ooh, actually mine is really hot too. Ooh.
That was not a lot. That was not a lot.
Mine got spicier as it went down.
Ooh.
Milk?
No, I'm gonna hold out.
Okay, here. I'm gonna get a glass of milk. Milk does the body good, yeah. Okay, all right, are you ready for a da-bomb? Toothpick on the cracker. Okay, is that enough?
A little bit more.
A little bit more, okay.
Keep out of touch of children.
Really?
Consume with one drop at a time.
Oh.
With extreme caution.
Should I take a little bit off?
You know what? We're gonna throw caution to the wind. Let's go.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah, that's surprisingly not bad.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
It's not really da bomb.
It's be, oh, no, there it goes. Oh, and oh. There.
Milk, okay.
Milk it, milk it.
Ah! Milk it, okay, oh, milk. Oh my goodness, okay. Okay, so we have de-bombed it. We have pain 100%ed it.
That did nothing.
Okay, are you sure that you're ready for the 1 million Scoville?
Uh-huh.
Okay, all right.
Bring it on.
Okay, I think that maybe we should just dip the toothpick slightly in it and then just dab it on your tongue. I don't think that we should be putting
it on. Kleenex, can we get some Kleenex? I feel my nose is running. Thank you. My eyes.
You're so strong and courageous. Good job, Ricky.
Thank you.
You have liquid coming out of your eyes and your nose. All right, I'm gonna dip it.
Okay.
All right, is that too much?
No, it's too much.
That's too much. Okay, how about, literally that is
okay,
like.
Okay, I'll take this one.
Okay,
I'll take
careful,
this one.
Don't get that end on your skin. Oh, you shouldn't have done the tip of your tongue.
Oh.
Really?
Yeah,
really?
The whole thing.
Okay. Oh my goodness. Okay, and now let's go to our next segment. You don't want to see this.
All right, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego.
And Daniel.
And Daniel. It's time to eat. We have all of the king's finest delicacies here, wine and meat, all for you. So take all as you wish.
Okay, hold on one second. I guess we're not gonna do the meat, wine thing, right? Yeah, no, we're not gonna do that. Okay, no, we'll have 4 vegetable plates and 4 glasses of water.
What?
4 vegetable plates and 4 glasses of water.
Are you sure? That sounds really gross. We have meat and wine, and it's delicious. It's all been dedicated to idols.
Yep, that's exactly. We're avoiding that. We are doing the vegetable and water diet only. We don't want the idol food.
Are you sure? It's much better. Mm-hmm. Trust me, you're going to be way healthier It's going to taste so good.
I'll tell you what. Test us for 10 days. Give us vegetables and water, and then see what we look like compared to the other men that eat the meat dedicated to idols.
Okay.
10 days.
Sounds like you're going to lose that bet, but you're on. I'll see you bozos in a week and a half.
All right.
Suckers.
Oh, man, I can't wait to dip my celery in water. Make it wet celery.
10 days later.
And then sometimes I pour water on the lettuce and it just, and I act like it's clear dressing.
Oh yeah, I do that too.
All right, so it's been 10 days now and I've brought one of my king's finest men here. His name is Steve. Say hello, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
He's a bit of a jokester. Anyway, Steve has only been eating and drinking wine and meat for 10 days.
How you feeling, Steve?
Well, I feel real healthy. I feel better than ever.
Can you do jumping jacks like this?
Nope, but I can do this. Does that look healthy?
That does not look normal.
Okay, how about this? Does this look healthy?
No.
I'm fine.
So, based on this test, are we free to keep eating what God told us to eat?
All right. You all are free to eat as you choose.
All right! We stood up for our beliefs! Woo! You know, courage is sometimes unpopular. Would you still stand up for what you believe in when you're tempted by the world to do something else?
Pop quiz, knuckleheads! You got a 50-50 chance on this one.
Were you paying attention to this, or were you just paying attention to these guys right here?
I don't like this guy right here. I don't care for him.
These two are on a date.
True or false?
We've never done true or false before. Let's do a true or false.
True or false. Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they didn't eat the king's food because they wanted to be healthy and fit. True or false?
True or false?
It's false. They didn't eat the king's food because they just wanted to be healthy and fit and have the best diet on the planet. They didn't eat the king's food because they were Jewish and they were following the law. So it was against their beliefs. Also, that food had been dedicated to idols, and you don't want food that's been dedicated to idols.
Hey, guys. Don't eat food that's been dedicated to idols. You either. That's gross.
Even under someone else's roof.
Even under someone else's roof.
They had the courage to do what they knew was right.
Even under someone else's roof, they still chose to do the right thing. I'm the quiz man. Goodbye.
Okay. Let's take an alternate look to the ending of the story. Ah, got all over me. Oh, it's snappy.
So alternate endings. They provide us with a what if. What if things don't go the way we plan? And this story has one of those. What if when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, when they went into the burning furnace, they didn't come out alive? And it's interesting because they actually talk about what if that happened themselves. They're quoted in Daniel chapter 3, verses 16 through 18, saying this. They're saying, King Nebuchadnezzar, we do not need to defend ourselves before you in this matter, because if we're thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it, and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. But even if he doesn't, we want you to know, your majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold you have set up. But even if he doesn't, would you still be able to stand up for what you believe in, even if there was no certainty that you would come out unharmed? If they took away your name, would you still stand up? If they told you that what you believe in is unpopular, would you still stand up? If they threatened your life, would you still stand up? If there was no assurance that you would be okay, would you still stand up? Every step of the way, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they could have given up. But every step of the way, they had courage to face what was in front of them because they knew who they were. They knew that popularity didn't matter. They knew that God was with them in the fire and out of it.
Gosh, these burning hot potato chips were hot. So, are you still glad that you like spicy food?
No, I think I'm done forever.
Do you know what you believe?
And will you do what's right, no matter what?
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. That's how you say it. Abednego. Nego. They showed great courage, and if you guys want to check out more of their story, you can check it out in Daniel.
And we'll also link to a video so you can dive deeper into the book of Daniel.
Thanks for hanging out with us, guys.
I'm gonna go dip my tongue in ice. Until next time,
enjoy the ride!
Hello, everyone. We're back. Did you enjoy that video? What did you learn, Coach David, about being courageous?
I learned that we need to stand up for the things that we believe in.
Yes, and we need to do more than just standing up physically.
Oh, yeah.
We need to proclaim the name of Christ and share his love with everybody in our lives. It's important for us to be his light in this world.
That's a pretty courageous thing to do.
It's true.
Yeah.
What else is very courageous to do?
You know, giving your life over to Christ and surrendering who you are to him and trusting in him as your Lord and Savior, that might be the most courageous thing I've ever done in my life.
Amen. I would agree. And if you've done the same today, we want you to tell a responsible adult in your life and let them know that God is now your Lord and Savior.
Absolutely.
We want to celebrate with you. When it's safe to do so, we're going to come back and have the biggest party ever.
Woo-hoo!
Until then, keep in touch with us through the YouVersion Bible app. There's lots of great things in there about what courage looks like. Download it to your phone, share it with your friends, and enjoy what God has for you in this life. We will see you next week.
Next week.
stands, and I hold true to the one who breaks my fall and lifts me time and time again.
Come on.
Oh my God, so good, you never give up.
Okay, when you sit in a chair, how many of you guys are afraid of it breaking underneath you, sending you careening to the ground in a crumpled pile of just sopping embarrassment? Me neither. Until that exact same thing happened to me, and it was awful. And in that moment, I realized, oh my gosh, I've trusted in chairs for so long, and I don't even think about it. And that's all of us do that exact same thing, right? Well, my point is this. It's really easy to trust in chairs, but God's promises are way more reliable than any chair. He promises to be our healer, our protector. He promises that he'll never leave us. Listen, as we worship, I want to encourage you to think about how much you actually trust God. I know it's hard. Sometimes I don't trust God as much as I should. But worship is a great time to check up on our faith and ask him to help us to trust him more deeply. Let's sing.
Breathe, breathe in your peace. Be the calm my fighting soul needs. When I'm weak, you are strong, and you say that I am yours. And fear, fear has no place, and the darkness cannot remain. As you speak over me, and you say that I am yours. The battle rages, but you have won the war. You see my sin, still you have called me yours. And there is no fear now that you. From the victory.